Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? Good. That's the way I'd put it. I'm good. Today on Ask Dotto Tech, we've got three burning questions you have. The first is regarding Gmail categories. The second is photos and Dropbox. And the third is sharing in Evernote. Oh, it is practically a celebration of cool tech today on Ask Dotto Tech. Ask Dotto Tech is the show where we have a very simple mathematical equation. You ask questions, I answer them. Where do you ask the questions? Right here in YouTube. You can just post a question into the comments area, or if you're a subscriber to my newsletter, reply to my newsletter with questions. That's another great way to get to me. But the whole deal is this. Ask me good questions, things that are important to you. I will do my best to answer them. I don't always get to answer every question, but I'll do my best to answer it clearly and concisely in the Dotto way. So let us begin. All three questions today have been generated from here in the YouTube channel. And the first comes from Steve, who says, Steve, how do I create categories, new categories in Gmail? Ah, Steve, you can't really create new categories in Gmail. Let's discuss how Gmail works. Gmail does this automatic filtering for us, which we see these three tabs or four tabs that I have above my demo account here of primary social promotions and updates. These are the what used to be controversial Gmail categories. Gmail assigned these global categories and sort email based on how they fit within those categories. Now, you can modify how they sort just by dragging email between them, but this pre-sorting or kind of email triage is something that some people like a lot and others don't. Now, the way we manage it, if you don't have it or if you do have it in your inbox and you want to modify it, is one of two ways. We can go under the settings and configure our inbox, which allows us to turn on and off. And it does a good job of explaining what each of these different categories can and should be, or how they look at it. There's also a little plus sign right up here that gives us instant access to the exact same dialog box. So we can basically turn on and off the categories here, but we can't do much other than that. We can just basically allow them to be. Now we can manage how they act. For example, if I'm in my social tab here and I want all of my YouTube email to be considered to be primary email, I could just drag that into my primary tab. And now any conversations that come from YouTube will be now put in my primary tab. So I have a little bit of control from that perspective, but not a lot more control. So you don't have the kind of granular control that you're probably looking for here, Steve. But I'm going to show you one other way that you might be able to control the content within Gmail a little more effectively. Two episodes ago, in episode 16, I showed you how to create labels. And we see the label that I created for the demo account here for my newsletter. And this is a very, just a straightforward, simple label that looks for all of the email coming in. That's a newsletter from Dotto Tech. And it places it here in my, it adds this tag to it. And I've color-coded it so that I can identify it. But I can also, if we go back into those labels, so we go back into settings where so much happens in Gmail, and we go back into those labels, you can see if I scroll down here that I've created a new thing called important stuff. What this is another label kind of underneath the top label, which almost turns the initial label into a category or into a section of its own. Let me show you how that happens. I'm going to create a new label, and I'm going to call it More Stuff. So you can imagine what that is, and I choose to nest it under one of my existing labels. So when by doing that, I kind of create a little bit of a hierarchical structure in my folders structure here, or in my label structure, so that now I've got these two additional storage areas of these two additional labels, so that I can create a little bit more hierarchy, a little more control over how I store and archive and manage my email. I don't know if that helps, Steve, but that's the only thing that I can come up with that allows you to customize the organization within Gmail. The actual official categories, uneditable, even though we can manage how they work. Next question comes from Brad, who says, Dotto, love your shows. It's one of my favorites. That's great. I have a question about Dropbox. I hate it that every time I plug my phone or my camera into my Mac, it uploads all my pictures into Dropbox. I just want them in iCloud. Help. Thanks in advance. You know, Dropbox is a little aggressive sometimes in how it does things when we first set it up. Here is how I discovered how to turn that particular feature off, because I was having the exact same problem. Is all of my photos were being loaded into Dropbox, which was taking up all of my Dropbox space, and it didn't matter because I actually use Google Photos. I like Google's photos as my backup system. So here's how we fix it. Just click on the Dropbox icon up in the menu bar, and there we find the gear setting. When you click on gear setting, you can go into preferences. In preferences, you find the import preference. Open the import preference and turn off the enable camera uploads. You can also modify it so you can choose just what to upload or where to upload things if you want to continue to upload and you want a little bit more control. But this is the magic sauce as far as importing photos into Dropbox. You set it right there. Hope that answers your question, Brad. And finally, Dietary One, who says, am I able to share an Evernote note with someone who does not use Evernote? I found how to share it, but if they don't have the app on their phone or home computer, it seems to get lost. No, it doesn't get lost. Let's just take this note here, which is all of my different questions for Ask Dotto Tech, and let's copy the public link. If I copy this public link, and then I launch a web browser of any sort, so your friend, whoever you send it to, you put them into a web browser here. We're going to go into Firefox, the web browser. I'm going to paste the URL, which you email to them by copying the public note. It then brings up in the browser instance that particular note. It shares the notes flawlessly. So regardless of which browser or which phone they are on, they can access all of your information, any information that you choose to share from Evernote, through this system. Just copying, going into the share menu in any Evernote note and saying copy the public link. If I choose that I don't want that link to be public anymore, I can stop sharing it at any point, in which case they will get a broken URL. But as long as you keep it public and you've copied the public link and you shared it with somebody, they will be able to open it in any browser. That's the way Evernote works. Well, I hope you found today's video to be useful. There's three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is, please, if you haven't subscribed to our channel. The second is, I encourage you to subscribe to our newsletter. That way you can ask me direct questions and you also hear about all of our upcoming live events, tutorials, webinars, etc. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel supported through the generosity of you at the crowdfunding site Patreon. I encourage you to drop by the Patreon page, have a look, discover what you can do to help keep me producing content like this for you, and there are perks if you choose to be a supporter of Dotto Tech, and the perks are awesome. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.